Hello everyone and welcome back to That Paradox Gaming. So we're back on the 1.7 server, and yeah, the pack has updated. We've got a few people have come to join us who are playing on the server from all over the world. It looks like really some people in the US can play, a lot of them can't. We've got one guy who's playing pretty well from Canada apparently, so welcome to everyone who's joined us. At the moment I'm joined by Hazzwold. And yeah, we're just going to go through what's going on. So as you can see, I'm in this room. This is a new room for my base. Some of you may have seen it from a previous video where we talked about the crafting recipes for power armor. Well, I just want to go through some of the Pneumaticraft stuff I've got going on here. But first off, Haz, say hello to our viewers.
Hello, YouTube!
He's been waiting forever to do that. First I just want to show, for those of you who enjoy Computercraft, Pneumaticraft has a lot of Computercraft support. Pretty much every block, has support. You can monitor pressure via computers. So you can see here, this is just counting up the pressure. Now this program has, failed me a couple of times, but, let's very quickly go into it just so you can get an idea. Basically, we're just wrapping. This is a flux compressor. It creates pressure, which goes through these tubes to different various machines. You can see some over here as well. And yeah, so this program basically is just monitoring the pressure by we're wrapping the flux compressor as a peripheral. And then we're just using this command here, fcomp.get pressure, and that returns whatever the pressure is. So then we're just saying if it's greater than whatever we want, than whatever it is, then we're going to get it to just change the output. Don't actually need this one because at the moment it's sitting on the back, but there you go, it can also be on the right. So we're just putting the redstone output here to let know whether to turn on or off. So you know, if it's greater than, turn it off. If it's not, that's fine, turn it back on. And we're just printing out the pressure on the screen. So it's a very simple program, but allows you to use some very fine control over how much pressure you're generating, which is great because it means we can actually keep stuff where it's just below the red line here, where there's a danger of stuff exploding, as you can see here on this pressure chamber. So I'm getting a feel for Pneumaticraft and you know how to program stuff with that. Here I've got a programmer for Pneumaticraft. Now this is to program these drones. And yeah, I'm having a play around with that, and I'm gonna see if there's anything cool I can do with Computercraft and drones, because they are nifty. If not, I'm still gonna have a play around with them, so stick around to see some stuff on that. Those of you who watched the previous video on the power armor and the recipes that we created to make power armor, if you haven't seen that, go back and watch it, because these assembly table with all the robot arms and stuff looks just neat. Nice. Well, that's probably about enough from this room. If you're interested in anything else, hit me up in the comments and maybe I'll get onto it next video. Now, something also kind of cool of Pneumaticraft, which I added, is right here. Now, I had a lift in here, if some of you might remember. What mod was that that added the lifts?
Dynamic transport. But it's a version behind, so we sort of had to take it out.
Yeah, so we had to lose dynamic transport. Well, luckily, Pneumaticraft is here to pick up the slack. Now, I hope I got enough pressure at the moment to run this thing. But, yeah, basically, Pneumaticraft adds an elevator. Oh, part of it's kind of stuffed up. I put a lot of speed upgrades in it, so it goes at a decent speed. I don't know what all these particle effects coming off me are, but it's kind of lagging out. It's, oh god, I'm a little concerned about crashing right now. There we go. Alright, so it got us here in the end. It's a kind of multi-block structure, and yeah, no, but it's quite neat. Yeah, so that's that. Actually, if we go back down, I might actually just teleport down to the bottom again. Oh, so I added another floor on the teleporter as well, because stuff having to use this thing fly through here all the time. So, the teleporter now does four levels. But as you can see, it's basically these, extending poles. So, if I, hit that again, what we should see, start to see soon at least, is, yeah, these poles kind of retracting. As the elevator comes down. It's kind of neat. Yeah, it took a lot of building. My God, the amount of stuff you need to build one of these things is actually ridiculous. But anyway, nice. Now, let's just... I made some little changes to the front of my base. Not entirely sure if I like it yet, but I don't know. I'm on a bit of a building kick at the moment. I kind of want to make some things. So, yeah, I don't know. These made these blocks, which are... I mean, yeah, these, like, pillars. I like how I used carpenter's blocks to make them kind of, you know, on a different... the, you know, 90 degree angle to all the rest of the blocks in the game, which I think looks kind of neat. Anyway, let's go over to Hazzwold's base, and for that, I have to go back downstairs and use the teleporter. Are you ready for me over there, Hazzwold?
I'm ready. Don't forget your RFID card, though, because...
Yes, I do have my RFID card. Thank you for that. Nice. All right, so is this teleporter still working? Apparently, yes. Okay, nice. Nice. Hazzwold's base. Now, I'm not sure if I've shown Hazzwold's base before. I think I did at one point. But if not, it's just amazing. And I'm kind of jealous and wish my base looked a bit more like this. Because, goddamn, it sucks. Nice. Oh, look at that. Nice collector. Oh, no, condensers you got over here. Was there any real need for that? Is that a little...
What? They're all... Oh, no, they're mostly full of wool and wire.
Oh, okay.
Having a lot of cable, but I only ended up using, like, two pieces.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I haven't actually looked at how these wings look coming out the back of, like, my jetpack, and I gotta admit, it actually looks pretty sick.
It is pretty sexy.
Oh, Jesus.
Don't go down there. I would not recommend it.
Oh, okay. Alright.
Do you want to check out the laser room?
Yes, the laser room. I'm not even entirely sure what the laser room... Wow, it's the laser room!
Right.
Far out. So just a few, you know. Jesus. That's trippy. Why does the laser, like, feed back into some of these? That's... Whoa. Wow. Just, like,
wish you
hadn't
said that, because now it's like it's drawing power out of it.
Yeah, it's weird, but nice, Jesus, that's quite a few lasers. Wow, you see, like, your meth lab underneath the joint.
Yeah, it's over here, somewhere. Ooh. Classic meth lab.
Classic meth lab. Actually,
Heisenberg hut.
Heisenberg hut. Oh Jesus, what am I doing? I could just use the stairs. Yeah, that looks just great. So good. So that's what, genetics and stuff, is it?
Yeah, this is entirely just the advanced genetics room.
Oh my God. Wow. Wow. I really would go get into mind cam. I keep meaning to do it, and I still haven't done it yet. Yeah, anyway, your base is just sex, and I do enjoy it quite a lot.
You should check out one last thing.
Oh,
the revamped Tesla coil.
Oh, the revamped Tesla coil, yes. Your Tesla
coil.
At
the moment, it's sort of just striking at air.
Oh.
Better.
Mine did that for a little while. Whoa! Jesus!
Red
How many...
indicates that it's turned on.
Really?
Yeah. It goes on and off. It's awesome.
Oh, that's awesome. And you've put, what, like, covers over it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that looks so fucking good. God damn. That's... But that is striking at a ferocious rate. Like...
Yeah, it actually runs, like, straight down. This is actually the dead center of that main room. And the roof of that main room is where the Tesla coil stops, so there's a lot to it.
Oh my God, I gotta say, like, mine does, like, one... Because this is doing, like, multiple strikes, like, at the same time. Because usually you see one little bolt of lightning. Oh my God, next Blood Moon, I'm coming here. Yes, Blood Moons are now a thing in this mod pack as well, which is kind of neat. Man, I love how you got the rings looking. What is that? Oh, it's just copper cable. Oh,
copper
that's
and HV
smart.
Cable, yeah.
Oh, dude, that looks so good. Yeah, the Blood Moons are crazy. For those of you familiar with Terraria, it's basically that. It's just a whole bunch of shit spawns. And, like, the normal spawn rules just don't apply. Start, like, a creeper will spawn right next to you. It's pretty messed up. So, Tesla coils are very good in that situation. All right, well, is there anything else you wanted to show us, man? That looks amazing.
You've been using RemoteIO, haven't you?
No. No, I have not.
Well, normally with Tesla coils, you got to chuck a tesseract and all sorts of control things on the actual Tesla coil block itself.
That's right.
It would look like dick, so, you know.
Yeah, it looks awful.
But if you stand on this middle grass block here, right next to, not the barbed wire.
Oh, hello. Oh, nice that, illusion.
That's actually a camouflage to look like a Tesla coil remote IO block feeding power up to the Tesla coil.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
What? Awesome. Oh. Okay, I'm going to play around with that. That's it. I'm definitely playing around with that. Because that's badass. Okay. Nice. Wow, that's cool. All right. Well, I guess we'll have to go into remote IO at some point because, yeah, that is sexy. Okay. One last thing to check out, and I'll probably do this for this episode, is Viktor has built a reactor. And he's built, well, one of those big reactors, but he's made a particularly big reactor. It is a big reactor. It is still loading in. There it goes. Oh, the lag. Holy FPS Batman. This is a reactor. I put this on Reddit and a lot of people, reacted to it. This is max size. Victor's not opt. He built this, you know, all by himself. It required over 100,000 enderpearls to make, or approximately 100,000 enderpearls to make all of this resonant ender. Those are actually all still blocks. They're not flowing. I think they're still like the flowing animation, but each one of them is actually a block of resonant ender. It's not like one block with then like one source block with a lot flowing off it. So he filled the whole thing up. He did it using like a floodgate, which looked really interesting, but even with a bunch of time torches on it, still apparently took about 12 hours to fill this thing up. It is an absolute monster. It outputs nearly 2 million RF per tick?
Yeah, 2 million or 1.5 million or something crazy.
I think it was like 1.8 or something. But yeah, it's a ridiculous amount. I don't really have to worry about maintaining the wither farm so much these days because this is ridiculous.
On the control panel, Will, at the moment, it's using 84 millibuckets a tick to generate 1.8 million RF a tick.
My God. Actually, yeah, I'll come down here to the control panel and everything so I can show you guys some stuff. So is that the reactor controls? There we go.
If you mouse over the power output, it actually shows you the exact number.
There you go. 1.7923 something something flux per tick. So that's 20 times a second it's putting out nearly 2 million RF, or 1.8 million RF. Just an absurd amount of power. This is also very cool. Basically, the EMC value for Eulorium being what is fueling the reactor. The reactor has an output of cyanide, which is, basically the waste generated by the reactor is cyanide. The cyanide has the same EMC value as Eulorium, so it's just converting his waste through a condenser, Project D condenser, is just converting cyanide straight back into Eulorium. So that's probably OP as hell, but oh well, no worries. It was a smart choice. Here's the power outputs and stuff. It's very, very cool. What's he making? Oh, right, love Eulorium.
To be fair, though, when you're generating that much power, you could do the same thing with laser drills, except it would be a whole lot laggier.
Ah, well, there you go. Well, no one needs to do that then. Nice. Well, anyway, so yeah, the biggest of big reactors. This is the max size that you can build, apparently. He went for cooling. Apparently, he could have put more rods in, but decided to go with more coolant. So, don't know why, but good for him. So it's making a butt ton of power. And yeah, well, guys, look, I think that's probably about it for this episode. Is there anything you'd like to add? Is there anything you want to say?
No, I tried to think of something offensive, but I don't have anything.
That's possibly for the best. Nice. Well, guys, again, hit me up if you're interested in joining the server. Really, It's probably best if you're in Australia, but you know, maybe West Coast America or somewhere America and stuff. Let us know. You can try it. If you're overseas, maybe try having a good, solid, you know, fast connection. But yeah. Anyway, hit me up in the comments. PM me if you want to join or you need the pack. And yeah, guys, look, I think that's about it. Thank you so much for watching. Hazzwold, pleasure as always.
Bye.
And I'll catch you guys later. Cheers.